wish this Christmas I'm gonna say a little prayer. I'm gonna stop here for a moment before the moment disappears. The world's in a hurry this December. The city streets and shopping malls. I wish we could slow down and remember the meaning of it all. Wherever you are.
Welcome to the gathering. It's good to see you. Merry Christmas Eve. Would you stand with us as you're able this morning? Go hug somebody and tell me you love them as we start to worship.
Of his love and wonders of His love. We will sing, sing, sing. Joy to the world. We will sing, sing, sing. Joyful, joyful, we adore Thee, God of glory, Lord of love. Hearts unfold like flowers before Thee, owing me to the Son above.
Friends, it is so good to be in worship with you this morning. Can you believe it is the morning of Christmas Eve? We are almost there. We are almost there. And there is so much joy that we can be thankful for this morning. We are so glad that you're here to worship. Whether this is your first time with us or whether this is somewhere that you're with us every Sunday, it is so good to have you here. I hope that you make yourself at home, whether you run for the first time. This is his first time walking with us on Sunday mornings. I hope you just make yourself at home in worship with us, and just know that we are here to worship God this morning. So let us pray as we continue to worship. God, thank you for this time together. Thank you that you have invited us here. So may we open our hearts and our lives as we continue to worship you this morning. Thank you for this time that we can slow our lives down, that we can worship you, and that we can just experience you in power and in truth. We pray in the name of Christ. Amen.
Would you stand with us as you're able? You were the child born in a manger, sent from God the Lord Most High. The Holy One sent down from heaven, born to set the captives free. What a beautiful name it is. What a beautiful name it is. The name of Jesus Christ, my King. What a beautiful name it is. Nothing compares to this. What a beautiful name it is. The name of Jesus. You didn't want heaven without us, so Jesus, you brought heaven down. The angels sang of your arrival, good news of great joy for mankind. What a wonderful name it is. What a wonderful name it is. The name of Jesus Christ, my King. What a wonderful name it is. Nothing compares to this. What a wonderful name it is. The name of Jesus.
gift sent from heaven, the child in a manger, the hope of the world, the gift for all. The heavens are roaring, the praise of your glory, Messiah the Savior of the world. You have no rival, you have no equal, now and forever, God, you reign. Yours is the kingdom, yours is the glory, yours is the name above all names. What a powerful name it is. What a powerful name it is. The name of Jesus Christ, my King. What a powerful name it is. Nothing compares to this. What a powerful name it is, the name of Jesus. What a powerful name it is, the name of Jesus. What a powerful name it is, the name of Jesus.
Grab a seat this morning.
Friends, each Sunday during Advent, we have come around these candles. We have lit these candles each Sunday. And I want you all to welcome the Kemp family. They're going to come on up. And as they come, I want you to be reminded of the candles that we have already been lighting. So the first candle was which one? You remember? The candle of hope. We're going to light that one. Which was the second candle? The candle of peace. I'm going to hand this one off to you all. He's going to take it. Asher's going to take it. Asher, you're going to take this and light the next one. These are hard to light because they have already been lit. All right, Asher, come light the third one. The pink one is which one? Joy. You'll have to pick it up a little bit, Asher. The joy. And then today, the Kemps are going to help us with the lighting of the fourth one. They're going to read a scripture, and then there will be a response upon the screen that we will all respond in. But first, hear the scripture.
It's from the book of John, chapter 3, verses 16 through 19. For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life.
For God did not send his Son into the world to condemn the world, but to save the world through him.
Whoever believes in him is not condemned, but whoever does not believe stands condemned already, because they have not believed in the name of God's one and only Son. This is the verdict. Light has come into the world, but people love darkness instead of light because their deeds were evil.
All right, we're going to respond with the words upon the screen as a congregation. So would you join me? We are a people who seek to be brought together by the love of Christ. Our faith teaches us that God gives us unconditional love and forgiveness. Acknowledging God's free gift of grace, we light the candle of love. Blow that one out. All right, good job, babe. Thank you. All right, thank you all so much. Friends, when you come tonight at 4 or 6 o'clock in the sanctuary for our Christmas Eve service, you will see all of those candles lit. The Christ candle is the center candle, and that is the candle we will light tonight. Our Advent wreath will be complete, and we will talk about that completeness tonight as we light that. As we come to a time of prayer, we take our joys and our concerns. So are there concerns that we would like to lift together this morning as we pray together? Concerns. Joe and Pam Mayo had a son who passed away unexpectedly on the 16th of December. So Becky is asking prayer for Joe and Pam Mayo. Other concerns? We've got a bunch of people traveling for Christmas. So I know I'll be traveling on Christmas morning to my family's. So bunch of people on the road. I know we've got a full evening of services, but we also have a Keith tradition of a live nativity that we do on, I don't know if y'all have seen it. It's a where we have a live nativity outside after our Christmas services, and one of the concerns in it this year is that we don't have enough people for the 6 o'clock shift, and that is something that Becky Smith, who sits up here on the front row, she is desperately looking for some people to fill the 6 o'clock shift tonight. So Becky, raise your hand if people can fill that shift tonight. We're looking for some wise men, some shepherds, some people to do the 6 o'clock shift tonight, right? Six people are needed. So if you're coming to the 4 o'clock service, you can stay for the 6 o'clock shift. Other concerns? Are there joys that we can share this morning? Yeah, Lil Wynn, who is Karen's mom, had a hip replacement. Took all of 45 minutes to do on Friday morning. And when I called to check on her on Friday afternoon, she was sitting in the car coming home. So she was just as perky and as upbeat as she ever is. And is doing exercises in her room and feeling pretty good. So we can be praying for Miss Lilwyn this morning. Jayla. Yeah! Christmas is turning 13. Happy birthday. Christmas baby, 13. What are we going to do? Any other birthdays tomorrow? Anybody else born on Christmas? No, nobody else is a Christmas baby? I know Barbara Catron is a Christmas baby. We celebrated that. Reagan, you're a Christmas baby? 29th, right after Christmas. All right. So you get birthday gifts and Christmas gifts? All right. You get them both. All right. For sure. Are there other joys that we can celebrate? What you got, Dallas? You celebrate all those gifts that you got at home? That Santa Claus is coming to your house? All right, so you're on the good list, right? You're on the good list? All right. All right, make sure you and your brother don't fight today so you don't get on the bad list, okay? I don't want you on the naughty list. I want you on the good list. All right. They said they have 51 presents at home. But they count them like 1, 33, 29. All right, other joys that we can celebrate. Absolutely. We continue to pray for Carol Pope, Carol and Chuck. Carol was diagnosed with third stage pancreatic cancer. Got good news on Friday that the cancer is, I guess, contained to the pancreas, is not spread to any other organs. So the good news is that she can begin chemo next week, have 6 weeks of treatment on that. Is it 6 weeks? I think it's 6 weeks of treatment. Of chemo and then possible surgery after that. So she's looking at a long battle of chemo and surgery, but they did receive good news. So continue to pray for Chuck and Carol. Sydney Mishtal is recovering well from her knee surgery, having just a few hiccups, but is doing well. She's got family in town this week, so that is very good. Any other joys that we can... All right, let us go to God in prayer today. Oh God, you are the one that loves us, and during this Advent season, a season of waiting, a season of expectation, we wait upon you. We wait upon you to fill us with hope, with peace, with joy, with love. We wait upon you to surround us with your presence, with your peace. Fill us with love. God, we just wait. And sometimes, God, that waiting is hard. Sometimes it's difficult. We want you to come now. We don't want to wait any longer. And yet, God, we ask for your patience as we wait. We wait expectation. We wait expectantly. We ask that you be with us in that waiting. And that during this season that we would know you. We would experience you. We would find you. God, be with us during this season and be with those who find this Christmas season just incredibly difficult, incredibly hard, incredibly long, and challenging. Be with those who are finding it hard to just wake up this morning. Be with those who are in the middle of grief and just find this season so difficult. But God, fill us with your joy of this season as well. Let us see the innocence of children, the compassion of people. Let us see the miracles of your life and your love. God, help us to see your truth and help us to find your presence in our lives. We pray this name, this day, in the name of Christ. Amen. Friends, we continue to pray this morning in an attitude of prayers. We invite you to bring your gifts. Baskets here on the altar, you can bring that. We also invite you to come up and light a candle of a prayer. There's some candles up here that we invite you to do that with. We invite you to a time of continued prayer a time of continued meditation as we continue to pray. How many of y'all love these Christmas songs? Love it. Raise your hand. That's right. Raise your hand. That's right. That's right. I'm going to ask a question. I'm looking straight at Mason. Mason, as Santa Claus is your witness, I want you to tell me the truth. as Santa Claus is your witness, do you always do what your parents tell you to do? Always? Is that a yes? You always do what your parents tell you to do, Robert? An orange key? Is that what you got? The right key. You got it, huh? So, Mason, you always do what your parents tell you? I'm going to take that as a mostly a yes, but sometimes it's hard, isn't it? So, grown-ups, y'all always do what your parents told you to do? It's hard, isn't it? I normally, as an adult now, my mom and I have this thing going on. She was watching the 9 o'clock service, basically ratted her out on live stream, you know, this morning on the live stream. She has this thing that drives me crazy. I mean, it drives me batty. And y'all are looking at each other saying, yeah, here it comes. She watches reruns, and she can watch the same show 15 times, and it doesn't bother her. And it drives me crazy. I'm like, Mom, we have seen this show. I could tell you the ending. I can tell you how it ends right now. She goes, I know how it ends, and then why aren't we watching the show? If we know how it ends, then why aren't we watching it? Well, I like this show, you know? Now, I can watch Christmas movies without any problem. I like watching the Griswold Family Christmas. You know? You like it, right? What's your favorite scene in the Griswold Family Christmas? It's when Uncle Eddie shows up, right? It's when Uncle Eddie shows up in town. Say, hey, Clark. Or the neighbors. The neighbors are my favorite, you know. Todd and Margo. You gotta love Todd and Margo. Yeah, old Margo. I don't know Todd. I can watch The Christmas Story. What's your favorite scene in The Christmas Story? When he gets his tongue stuck to the flagpole. Every time. I can watch that 100 times. I don't mind watching that rerun. But there's something about watching TV shows with my mom when watching NCIS for the 20th time that just kind of grates on my nerves, you know, because I've seen it before. But sometimes watching reruns, when we know how the story ends, we can listen to the story a little more intently. Because we know how the story ends, we can listen to it. We know the storylines. We know the characters. We can see how the story ends and listen to it in a little of a deeper way. Friends, we already know how the Christmas story ends, right? We already know that Mary and Joseph get together. We already know that they travel from Nazareth to Bethlehem. We already know that, you know, that there's no place for them to stay, no appropriate place for them to stay, that they have to go to a barn. That's what one of the kids, I was talking to some kids this week, and I said, was Jesus born in a palace? They go, no! Jesus was born in a barn. All right. Jesus was born in a barn. We're going to go with that. We know that Jesus, we know that there were shepherds, there's angels. We know the ending, right? Now we can concentrate on the story. I want you to hear the scripture today, maybe in a new way. In a way that maybe you've seen it. Maybe we're going to watch a clip of the Peanuts clip of the Christmas story. Maybe you've seen it, maybe you haven't, but maybe this will remind you in a new way of Luke's Christmas story.
I guess you were right, Linus. I shouldn't have picked this little tree. Everything I do turns into a disaster. I guess I really don't know what Christmas is all about. Isn't there anyone who knows what Christmas is all about?
Sure, Charlie Brown. I can tell you what Christmas is all about. Lights, please. And there were in the same country shepherds, abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night, and lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them. And the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were sore afraid. And the angel said unto them, Fear not, for behold, I bring you tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign unto you. You shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host praising God, and saying, Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men. That's what Christmas is all about, Charlie Brown.
Isn't that great? You know what my favorite part of that is? I mean, the scripture, of course. Is Linus comes to the very end and he just simply says, that's what Christmas is all about, Charlie Brown. Just very simply. That's what Christmas is all about. Christmas. So here is Joseph and Mary. They're in a strange place. Joseph had been to Bethlehem because this is the place of his heritage, of his lineage. But Mary had never been there. Bethlehem is crowded. It is just flooded with people because of the census. And there's no appropriate place for them to stay because of Mary's pregnancy. But they find a stable, a barn. That they are able to stay in. When Jesus is born, they place Jesus in a manger, a feeding trough for animals. As I was talking to some kids earlier this week, I was asking them where Jesus had a bed, and they said, and I asked him, I said, do you think Jesus had a comfortable bed? They said, Jesus slept on hay. I said, you think Jesus slept on hay? Somebody said, Jesus slept near a horse, is what a kid said. And Jesus slept near a horse. Kids have a way of just telling you, right? So isn't it the truth that Jesus slept near a horse in a trough? A humble place where Jesus was born. And isn't it interesting that Jesus was born in this barn, as the kids said? And the first people to see Jesus were the most ordinary people of the day. Not the kings, not the most important people of the day, but the shepherds who were out doing their job in the fields. And the angels come, and we'll hear more about the angels tonight when you come to the Christmas Eve service, but the angels come to the shepherds and give them this wonderful message. And the angels' message was this great news of great joy to all people. And the shepherds were so excited that they come, and they set out to find baby Jesus. And they find him. And what do you think they do? They worship him. They worshiped him. Now think for just a minute that you're in Mary and Joseph's shoes. You're in a strange place, surrounded by strange people. Mary and Joseph are exhausted from traveling, from giving birth. She's surrounded by people she doesn't know. And it's crazy to think that this is how God enters the world. It's crazy to me to think that this is how God chooses to make himself known. But at the very heart of the Christmas story lies the truth that carries us through every single day. That God loves the world so much. And we heard it in the scripture that the Kemps read for us, John 3:16. That God loved the world so much that he gave his son. Here's Jesus in a manger. He gave the Son to the world. God taking on flesh and blood in the form of Jesus. See, friends, I need to be reminded of how much God loved the world when my world is falling apart. When I feel abandoned and I feel like nobody cares for me and everything is going against me, I need to be reminded that God is fighting for me, right? When it feels like evil is winning and there's nothing good happening in our world, we need to be reminded that God is there for us. And what I love is that the promise that we have at Christmas. And we talked about the promises of Isaiah, the promise of Emmanuel, which means what? God with us. The promises of Emmanuel is not just for one day at Christmas. The promises of Emmanuel is a promise for today and tomorrow. And for every day of this year, and for every day of next year, and the year to come. The promises of Emmanuel is what we find here in this Advent wreath. And it's not just a pretty wreath that we light just to have the candles here at Christmas. It's so much more than that. Because every time we light this candle of hope, it's a prayer that there is hope that God is putting into our life that is so much greater than the hopelessness that people feel in life. That there is hope that God will give us that is so much greater than what we feel in this world. Every time we think about this candle of peace, and I don't know if you can see it, look how small it is. You see how small it is? You actually have to bend it over to make it big because it was really, really small. And then when I put it up, it gets small again. The wick is so small. And sometimes peace is like that, isn't it? Peace is so temperamental. You look at peace in our world and it is so temperamental. And you're thinking, you know, there's so many places of war. There's so many places in our city and in our nation, in our world that are so temperamental. And we think, oh my gosh. How can we ever find peace? Every time we light this candle, it's a prayer of peace. That there would be peace in our life. There would be peace in our world. There would be peace in all places of our world. We light the pink candle, and I love the pink candle. Which one is the pink? Joy. We sang Joy to the World this morning in our first service, and I told them that If they didn't sing with joy, that we are going to stop and we are going to sing it again. Because you can't sing joy to the world with the faces like y'all have on right now. You got to sing joy to the world with joy. And with joy, with the joy candle, it's a prayer that God would send us joy. Not for just one moment. But God would send us joy that would go into our hearts. And that would be greater than any circumstance we would have in our life. That in the days that are the worst days, we would have joy. In the days that are our best days, we would have joy. That in the days that we just can't take one more step, guess what? We would have joy. And then today we lit the candle of love. A reminder that God's love embraces all. Embraces all of who we are. Embraces every step that we take. Embraces everyone regardless of who they are, what they've done. Embraces us with a never-ending love for all of our life. Friends, this is the hope of Advent. And it's all possible because of the center candle. It's all possible because of Emmanuel, the Christ. And I know it's not Christmas Eve. It's not Christmas Eve yet, is it? It's not Christmas yet, is it, Robert? And Mike is not liturgically correct. But I'm going to do it anyway. Friends, this is the Christ candle. And this is a sign on this morning of Christmas Eve that the Christ candle, the Christ, is with us all. Emmanuel. And that's a promise that God is with us. Period, exclamation point, take it to the bank. That God is with us now, and God is with us always. And all God's people said, amen. Let us pray. God, thank you for your love that always surrounds us, it's always with us, always cares for us, always intercedes for us. Thank you for your love that is always reaching out to us in love, compassion, forgiveness. Continue to watch after us, continue to reach out to us with your unfailing forgiveness and unfailing love. For it's in the name of Christ that we pray. Amen.
Would you stand with us as you're able this morning?
Oh, holy night, the stars are brightly shining. It is the night of the dear Savior's birth. Long lay the world in sin and error pining, till he appeared and the soul felt its worth. A thrill of hope, the weary world rejoices, for yonder breaks a new and glorious morn. Fall on your knees, oh, hear the angel voices. when Christ was born. All night, divine. All night, divine. Truly, He taught us to love one another. His law is love, and His gospel is peace. Chains shall He break, for the slave is our brother, and in His name all oppression shall cease. Sweet hymns of joy in grateful chorus raise we, let all within us praise His holy name. Fall on your knees, oh, hear the angel voice. Christ was born. Oh, night, divine. Oh, night, divine. Fall on your knees. Christ was born.
Friends, a couple of things before we leave. This time next week, if you are in this place for 11 o'clock worship, you are late. We are combined next week for worship at 10 o'clock in this space. So worship next week is at 10 o'clock. It is a service of songs by Josh and scriptures by Mark. There is no sermon. So that's the good news. So 10 o'clock here, the whole services are combined at 10 o'clock in this space next week. Come, and it's a service of songs and scripture. I will be out of town, but Pastor Mark and Josh will lead you in that service. We do have Christmas Eve worship tonight at 4 o'clock and at 6 o'clock in the sanctuary. We'd love to have you worship with us tonight. Come see Miss Becky before you leave if you're able to help with the 6 o'clock live nativity. Please have a blessed Christmas celebration. With the peace of Christ, go with you. Go in peace. Amen.